the summer sun is fading as the year grows old, and darker days are drawing near. The winter winds will be much colder. I watch the birds fly south across the autumn sky, and one by one they disappear. I wish that I was flying with them. Now you're not here. Like a song through the trees, you came to love me. Like a leaf on a breeze, you blew away. Autumn's golden gown, we used to kick our way. You always love this time of year. Those fallen leaves lie undisturbed now. Cause you're not here. Cause you're not here. Cause you're not here.
Suddenly leapt from house to house. The population panicked and ran, and I was swept along with them, aimless and lost without carry. Finally, I headed eastward for the ocean and my only hope of survival, a boat out of England.
A gentle rain falls softly on my weary eyes, as if to hide a lonely tear. My life will be forever autumn, cause you're not here. Cause you're not here. Cause you're not here.
As I hasten through Covent Garden, Blackfriars and Billingsgate, more and more people join the painful exodus. Sad, weary women, their children stumbling in the street with tears, their men bitter and angry, the rich rubbing shoulders with beggars and outcasts. Dogs snarled and whined, the horses' bits were covered with foam, and here and there were wounded soldiers, as helpless as the rest. We saw tripods wading up the Thames, cutting through bridges as though they were paper. Waterloo Bridge, Westminster Bridge. One appeared above the...
The steamer began to move slowly away, but on the landward horizon appeared the silhouette of a fighting machine. Another came, and another, striding over hills and trees, plunging far out to sea and blocking the exit of the steamer. Between them lay the silent, grey, ironclad Thunder Child. Slowly it moved toward shore, then with a deafening roar and whoosh of spray, it swung about and drove at full speed towards the waiting Marshal.
There were ships of shapes and sizes scattered out along the bay, and I thought I heard her calling as the steamer pulled away. The invaders must have seen them as across the coast they filed, standing from between them. There lay Thunder Child, moving swiftly through the waters, cannons blazing as she came. Brought a mighty vessel, warlord, crashing down in sheets of flame. Sensing victory was nearing, thinking fortune must have smiled. People started cheering. Come on, Thunder Child. Come on, Thunder Child.
The Marshal Martians released their black smoke, but the ship sped on, cutting down one of the tripod figures. Instantly, the others raised their heat rays and melted the Thunder Child's valiant heart.
Sinking wreck, with the smoke of battle clearing, all the brave